Good morning, everyone. My name is Kyle Ripley, and I'm the director of the Calgary 2026 Olympic Bid Project. Thank you for joining us today. I am pleased to be here on behalf of all of the Calgary 2026 Olympic Bid Project team. I'd like to thank the Canadian Sport Institute for hosting us here this morning. This site is an example of the legacy of 1988 Games and how we can continue to support the development of our sport and our athletes through hosting the Olympic Games. We know that Calgarians are keenly interested in the status of the 2026 Olympic project, and we want to keep everyone as informed as possible as we proceed through the bid process. The International Olympic Committee was in Calgary last week for an interactive working session with the Calgary 2026 Olympic Bid Project team. This working session is part of the IOC's new candidature process, which provides a more meaningful support for interested cities in advance of making a bid. Previously, an interested city would have submitted a concept and documentation to the IOC without such support. Under the new model, the IOC is co-constructing Calgary's potential bid, providing feedback and detailed information before Calgary has even decided to proceed with the bid for 2026. This support means that if Calgary proceeds with the bid, it will be with a smarter and more sustainable games concept. The visit was very productive. Our project team was able to openly discuss our plans and challenges, and we learned a great deal about the new candidature process and the new IOC criteria. The IOC experts were also able to visit our legacy facilities, which helped us better understand our ability to host the games in 2026. One of the IOC's changes includes a new emphasis on making use of existing facilities. The IOC is adamant that no new facilities be built for the games unless there is an existing need or a strong business case for this facility with or without the Olympics. For example, under the previous model, our Olympic Oval, which is still some of the fastest ice on Earth, would have been about 6,000 spectator seats too small to host an Olympic event. Now, under the new IOC model, our Olympic Oval would be considered suitable to host the same Olympic event. The IOC is also encouraging interested cities to look beyond city borders for competition venues. And this is in line with City Council's direction in November for us to look to Whistler and Edmonton to explore events like ski jumping and curling. Now, we are still exploring these possibilities, as using existing facilities in different cities in different provinces can be a capital cost savings for a host city, but it also raises additional logistics, security considerations, and expenses. Now, there were several key takeaways from our meetings with the IOC. The IOC reiterated that all decisions should be reviewed through the lens of sustainability and legacy. The IOC wants to make sure that a host city can responsibly manage the games and that the city will benefit from the games well beyond the event itself. Another takeaway is that affordability is an important consideration for an interested city. The more relaxed venue capacity requirements are certainly a capital cost savings measure. And for Calgary in particular, the fact that we regularly host World Cup events means that we wouldn't need to conduct as many Olympic test events, which would be an operational cost savings should we pursue the games. We also heard that the IOC believes that Calgary would be an incredible host city. Thanks to our legacy infrastructure from the 1988 Games and to our commitment to winter sport excellence, our volunteerism, and our diversity. We pride ourselves on these things, and so it was wonderful to hear that those values are apparent to our international colleagues. So what happens next? Calgary City Council has directed the project team to pursue funding commitments for a possible bid corporation from the other two orders of government. We expect to confirm these commitments one way or another by early February. If the funding commitments are secured, City Council would need to make a decision on the balance of funding for the bid corporation. And the IOC would make additional visits to Calgary between March and June of this year. And we expect Council to make this decision about pursuing the bid by late March. We currently plan to send a delegation to the PyeongChang Observer Program. The Observer Program gives interested cities an opportunity to experience the Winter Games firsthand and meet with experts about all aspects of games management, which truly would support the development of a stronger bid for Calgary. If we learn before the PyeongChang Games that the other orders of government will not provide a funding commitment, or if City Council decides not to pursue a bid, we have arranged for insurance to cover our cancellation costs if necessary. Now, before we go to the questions from the media, I would like to thank the IOC for their visit last week. I would like to thank the Canadian Olympic Committee for their participation and support. I would like to thank the Government of Canada and the Government of Alberta for their support and consideration of our request. And I'd once again like to thank the Canadian Sport Institute for hosting us this morning.